The gods only know what grand company our adventurer friend will keep. The wheels of change are in motion regardless.
Brother, are you certain this course is best?
Whatever do you mean, dear sister?
The so-called remembrance ceremonies were little more than standard waving rallies. As though the Calamity and Seventh Umbral Era warranted scarcely a mention.
Well, of course they were standard waving rallies. Since you are so observant, mayhap you noticed what mention was made of the Warriors of Light? None. I suppose they must have forgotten the heroes who spared Eorzea a fate worse than the Calamity? No, dear Alizé, they haven't forgotten these details. They have elected to omit them. Deep are the wounds the Calamity inflicted upon Eorzea. So deep, in fact, that the realm still bleeds. Needless to say, the beast tribes and their primals do little to alleviate the pain. So, the task of salving Eorzea's wounds falls to the Scions of the Seventh Dawn, with a little help from our friends, the Grand Companies. Remembrance will yield no remedy. If our world is to heal, we must put the horrors of the Calamity behind us.
Grandfather would never entrust the fate of the realm to despots who rewrite history to their convenience. There must be another way to cure what ails this world, and I need to find it.
You are most welcome to try. Our paths may differ, but our destination is the same. In time, I dare say we will see eye to eye.
I should hope so.
My lady!
We are to escort you!
Hope does not come into it. We share the burden of this fate, dear sister, and will prevail together or not at all. The salve will serve not only to close up our present wounds, but prevent old ones from opening anew.
Thank you. Thank you. Now, having set aside the formalities, we have a favor to ask of you. Uriange, have the documents arrived from the students of Baldessian?
Aye, my lady. They arrived but recently.
We have conducted a study at the behest of the Order of the Twin Adder. Popolimo, Ida, a synopsis, if you would.
Our task was to survey the behavior of the Sylphs, a beast tribe indigenous to the Twelveswood.
Oh, how to describe them. They look like Gisselgreens, floating ones, that worship the primal Ramu.
Ahem. Though technically a beast tribe, Sylphs are blessed with a comparatively personable demeanor, conducive to peaceful communication.
Offering us an invaluable opportunity to learn what the beast tribes know of the primals.
While Ramu's existence is well documented, the Sylphs do not, or perhaps cannot, summon the primal any longer, insofar as can be ascertained. Until such time as we know, it would be unwise to assume that the threat posed by the primal has passed.
Which leaves Gridania with the added worry of not knowing what they should be worrying about.
In that regard, they are hardly alone. What we can say with absolute certainty is that Gridania has its hands full fending off Garuda, who, I need hardly remind you, is among the most savage and terrible of all known primals.
In short, it is essential that we approach the Sylphs in as diplomatic a manner as possible. Words and actions can be misconstrued. The only sure way to communicate our intentions is the Echo. Winning the Sylph's favor may well bring us a step closer to mitigating the threat of the primals. Will you help us? I am grateful.
Lovely. Well, as much as I'd like to help, I'm afraid I would be of little use to anyone in Gridania. A veritable babe in the woods. Ida and Papalimo, however, should be able to see the forest for the trees. Is that not so, Minfilia?
Indeed. You are willing?
Leave it to me.
Us, Ida, us!
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.